from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse, pull me like a ripcord, break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip, word upon your lip, lip, better that you rip, rip, break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Ryan's Falcons going up against Manning's Giants.
All right, Larry, thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their men in blue emerging from the MetLife tunnels. We're set to go as the Giants get ready to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he's a big factor in a run game, no gain.
It's caught by OBJ. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back near the 25. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown.
I don't think there's any doubt that that was not a very good throw by Eli. And, you know, part of what happens is he's a little bit of a slinger, all right? Take his shots, and in this case, it backfired.
Worth noting, you remember 2007 against the Vikings, three pick sixes Manning had in that game, tied for the most in a game in NFL history.
They'll study his career. They've thrown the ball downfield a lot. That's where you'll accumulate a few more interceptions.
CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs, Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis, some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins, and about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks, DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names that could be out there as free agents.
Manning to throw on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Throwing is Manning on third down. He finds Beckham complete. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. Now Darquan. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 12 more yards there and another first down.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Left side, it's Beckham. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now they'll run it on the toss. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
The Giants on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. Working from the gun, Manning, and they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Leroy Reynolds coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. And the kick by Rosas is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
It's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
After the field goal, here's Rosas to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And some space here.
Sidesteps him at the 35. And it'll be a terrific return here as he gets it down all the way inside the 30.
But whatever the relationship was between the special teams and the offense, it's gotten a heck of a lot closer after a return like that. The special teams just keep setting them up. The offense thinks they'll go out there and knock them down.
In motion is Austin Hooper. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. About 3 yards there to the 27.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
Now Ryan on second down. The left side completion to Jones. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. A phrase we said a lot last year, Ryan to Jones for a Falcon first down. In the red zone this time. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Here's Coleman. Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Tevin Coleman, a 13-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Beats good tackling on that play. And
now here's Bryant to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. So the football switching hands here in just a second. And, you know, Tom Brady, just to go off on a tangent for a second, may have lost the Super Bowl, but third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last 9 NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl that same season, 0-9.
Yeah.
You go all the way back to Kurt Warner in, what, 1999, where he won the double?
We were going over that stat earlier. That is hard to believe.
But he would have been the MVP had the Patriots pulled that one out.
Yeah, he still has 5 rings, though, 5 Super Bowl titles for Brady. Second down, here's Manning. And a loose football. But I believe the Giants got this back, and they will hold on to the possession. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you talked about in all your preparation for the game. And you probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Darquan, and a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. On play action, it's Manning. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
A lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. The Giants on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and seven. Throwing is Manning. He finds his target, Beckham. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Now they'll run it on the toss. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. They'll run with Darquan. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13. The Giants on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Throwing now is Manning. And that is incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Online, but off the crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. So the missed 56-yarder, and now the flip side. Good starting field position at the 46 near midfield. They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. Looking deep for Julio. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
Well, one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right. And this is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Julio Jones, 54 yards, and the Falcons will extend their lead. And it's 21-3. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. Now a hit and a loose football. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Before the offense changes hands here, let's flip back to the Super Bowl February 5th. What a game. I know you were there calling it offensively, though. Impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles, the backup quarterback turned MVP, 373 yards, 3 touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off-air, it was just a fluid game, not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game and, of course, people in attendance. A really well-played game.
It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. They'll run here with Freeman. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Coleman now. that, he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tevin Coleman with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line.
For the New York Giants, as their offense comes back out there, yeah, last year, 3-13, and that was off from just a year of being a playoff team at 11-5. They were 31st in total points, 31st in overall defense, so a lot of changes need to take place.
They certainly do, and frankly, the 11-5 season masked the changes that are coming now because their numbers weren't that great in the 11-5 season. Somehow they found a way to win those key important games and accumulate a nice record, but you look at the underpinnings and you'll see the cracks are already there, and they really got exposed in 2017. They'll hit the restart button and do it and have a do-over.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. And it looks like a pickup of 6. That leaves him with 7 yards to go on third down.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. To throw on third down, Manning. It's caught. Beckham. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, need to do something to get more than that 3 number that they have on the scoreboard right now. So the offense has it 1st and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. They fake the handoff. Now Manning. Looking for his receiver. Sharp, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
Well, before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the ball. Sean McVay deserving, I think you would agree, of Coach of the Year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what he did for the Rams when they went from last in the league in scoring to leading the league in scoring and winning a division title. And how about the New Orleans Saints, Rookie of the Year, offense and defense. Alvin Kamara on offense, Marshawn Lattimore on defense.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Damon Harrison busting through to get him for a loss of 6. On 2nd down, Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are. This is caught. It's Sanu this time for a foul.